Agencies and pavement owners today are facing a big challenge in maintaining roadways due to dwindling revenues for roadway maintenance. Because of this, a variety of treatments classified as pavement preservation techniques are increasingly used to extend the life of a pavement. These products are tools for state and local agencies and are intended to keep good pavements in good condition. Many agencies are exploring several preventive maintenance alternatives to improve the overall condition of their pavement network. It's important to realize that since preventive maintenance products are placed thinner than traditional asphalt overlays, they are only recommended for use on existing road surfaces that are still in good or fair condition. There is a rating system in place that scores pavements and ranks them by their condition. In the majority of cases, a preventive maintenance treatment should be placed on a roadway that is relatively new, where the driving public would probably not observe much distress. Here is an example of a pavement that is having a preventive maintenance treatment applied the very same day this video was recorded. You can see that the roadway remains in very good condition, so this treatment should significantly extend its service life. Logically, project selection is the single most critical element to a successful preventive maintenance application. The best roadway candidates are those with minor surface deterioration, such as raveling or oxidation. Most preventive maintenance treatments are not effective and not recommended when the existing pavement surface exhibits more serious distress, such as rutting or alligator cracking. Roads with structural failures or severely distressed pavements are certainly not good candidates for any preventive maintenance treatment. These require isolated base failure repairs, as well as a thicker overlay. While preventive maintenance techniques are designed to extend the life of the road, quantifying that extension is difficult. The condition of the underlying pavement is critical to the performance of any new treatment, and as a result, preventive maintenance performed on badly distressed pavements provide very little benefit. In contrast, they can provide a significant extension in pavement life when placed on pavements that are structurally sound and in good or fair condition. When evaluating pavement economics, examining initial cost and the years of expected service life allows an agency to calculate a cost per mile per year. That information provides valuable data for making decisions on the right treatment application for the roadway while stretching limited funds. In response to these agency concerns about their pavement networks, the asphalt industry has developed a product called Thinlays to address the growing need for pavement preservation and preventive maintenance. Thinlays utilize the same aggregates and liquid asphalt as a traditional hot mix asphalt mixture, but they are designed with smaller aggregates, which allows the mixture to be placed at a thickness of 5/8 to 1 inch. A traditional asphalt overlay ranges from 1 1/4 to 1.5 inches in thickness. These treatments can address minor irregularities and can improve the smoothness and ride quality of the roadway. Thinlay mixtures are produced in a hot mix asphalt plant, transported to the project location in dump trucks, then placed and compacted with traditional asphalt pavers and rollers. These projects utilize local contractors and materials, and therefore provide maximum benefit to local communities. For more technical information on Thinlays, refer to the NAPA Information Series 141 document titled Thinlays for Pavement Preservation. It is available for download at asphaltpavement.org. With an array of products on the market, owners and agencies are forced to look closely at the overall benefit and cost effectiveness of any pavement treatment option. Thinlays are a proven technique that can help agencies maintain their road network while providing excellent value to the motoring public and taxpayers.